so I can be with you in eternity. Why is it so hard for people to understand that Jesus is the only way to salvation?
Well, most people understand that, and they already know this, and they accept it, but they know their sin, and they know living in darkness more than anything in this world,
and they don't want to lose everything just like Tim Diddy. Look at Tim Diddy. Look at Tim Diddy.
For them, he's not to bring anybody to go there. He can bring them down there. Doesn't matter where you're at. It matters where your soul is at. He can bring you from there to down here in the heart. Amen. Look at Nebuchadnezzar.
How many of you read the Bible and know about Nebuchadnezzar?
Nebuchadnezzar was the richest man in the Old Testament. He was the richest man. He had all the money, all the land, everything. Women, he had everything. And he kept saying, my this, my that, my. He was living in the my generation. And he didn't give God any of the glory whatsoever. And the more he got, the more he said about what he had. And how he earned it. So God said, okay, I'm going to have to teach this season a lesson. So he turned them into a beast. God turned Nebuchadnezzar into a beast. And for 7 years he was living off the land, off the vegetation in the land. Just 7 years, he was a beast. God took everything away from him. Because he refused to give God any of the glory for anything that God gave him. So after 7 years, Nebuchadnezzar said to God,
God, I'm so grateful. I realize that you have all the power, you have all the authority. And it's only for you that I have been fortunate to have these things.
And not only did God forgive him and change him back to his original Nebuchadnezzar, he multiplied everything that he had. And Nebuchadnezzar began to know that there's only one true God. There's only one true God. And he's not worshiping and giving homage to all the false idols. And to himself. Because I don't care how righteous that you think you are, you're not righteous without Jesus. I don't care about how good you think you are, you're not good without Jesus. I don't care about how much you think you can do for yourself. You can't do nothing without Jesus. I didn't say that. Jesus said, without me, you are nothing. Without me, you are nothing. You have nothing, and you will be nothing. Oh, they always stood up in here. You know what they mean? All these people chasing after these materialistic things. They become idols. They become idols. Your car is your idol. Your house is your idol. Your money, your finances is your idol. It's written, yes, the most. But it doesn't matter how many houses you have, how many cars you have, how much bank account, how much money you have in your bank account, that means nothing to Jesus, because he said, without him, you are nothing.
You
You are still nothing.
You might think there's something in your head. You might think you have all the money. You might think you have a nice house and a nice car and enjoying it. You might think you have everything you need.
But if you don't have Jesus, you don't have what you need the most.
Wait for the Holy Ghost.
And you need him to be your host.
And then,
stop that idolizing what you have in this world.
And start realizing that it's the blood of Jesus that will set us all free from this wicked nation.
Amen.
Not a wicked nation.
Not just wicked America.
Because the whole nation is filthy right now.
God said, none of us are worthy. None of us.
He said, none of us.
That means everybody in this world right now.
None of us.
Not just America, but the whole world.
And I'm going to let y'all know,
when the gospel,
when the church has been evangelized,
and the church is complete,
that's going to be it.
That's going to be like, you know how the referee says, time out!
Time out!
That's going to be it.
There's an infection on the field.
That's going to be it for all of us.
The Holy Spirit shall depart on the earth.
When the gospel has been preached to all the nations.
So everybody that's thinking of God's grace is forever, it's not.
We are on a time limit with Jesus right now.
And we are on probation with God.
Let me repeat that.
We are on a time limit with Jesus right now.
And we are on probation with God the Father.
God's grace is for a period of time.
And the Father will live compassion
and for Jesus' Son,
that it has been extended.
It has been extended.
God wanted to end this wicked world a long.
I can't even say long enough time for our special thing.
But a long time ago,
this world should have ended a long time ago.
But God loves us so much that He left.
He gave us what?
The only Son.
That's why my sister.
Because He said, you know what?
I'm not going to get rid of the world right now.
I'm not going to give up that easily.
I think there is a chance.
So what could I do to make sure that they come?
What could I do?
I know, huh?
I'm gonna send myself to
Earth.
Jesus is God made manifest in the flesh.
God made manifest in the flesh.
All y'all think that Jesus was just a man.
Oh, a lot of people say Jesus was just a preacher.
Or a servant of the...
Jesus was God made manifest in the flesh.
God made manifest in the flesh.
God said, I'm going to send myself to them.
So that they'll have
one last chance.
I'm going to give them one last chance.
This is going to be their last chance.
If they don't listen,
okay,
I'm going to flip the switch.
No more world.
I'm going to flip the switch.
No more world.
That means no more you,
no more me,
no more any of us.
Because God's going to flip the switch.
Believe that.
He's still going to flip the switch.
When Jesus comes,
He's going to flip the switch.
But instead of doing it back then,
He said, I'm going to give him one last chance. That's why he came to earth to give us another chance. To give us all another chance. And what do we know when he comes? When he came, we put him on the cross. He crucified him. Because we still rejected him. Amen. But through the blood of Jesus, we have another chance. This is like going to say, when you're watching a movie on Netflix and you see the end credits, it's the end of the movie. It's going to be the end of this movie when Jesus comes. It's going to be the end of everything when Jesus comes. Amen? Amen. And if your name is not written in the Lamb's Book of Life, you will not have eternal salvation with Jesus. You will be to the lake of fire. Amen. There's two books in heaven right now. There are two books in heaven. The Book of Life, which is the book of everybody in this world. And it tells us, and it says everything you've ever done, everything you ever said, how you acted and how you lived. That's the Book of Life. God already knows about you. God knows you better than you know yourself. And there's the Lamb's Book of Life, whose names are written, all that are saved, all that have accepted Jesus as their Savior. Amen? Amen. So I'm going to end on this note. I'm going to end on this note. Come to Jesus today, because you don't have that much time. Come to Jesus today, because we do not have that much time left. Because Scripture says, when the world is evangelized and the church is complete, Jesus will come to sweep us off of our feet and take us with him to that heavenly place. And I can't wait to see my Lord and Savior Jesus face to face. And give him a warm and good.
Am I right about it?
Yeah!
Preacher, are you taking a break? No, I'm going to leave it on.
All right.
Where you going to be?
Right there when I preach.
Okay, I'll put it right here. And don't move so much. You're like a jumping bean.
Ready, fire.
Yes,
fire.
I'll be back.
All right. Amen. Hallelujah! Glory to God! Glory to God! Glory to God! You serve an awesome God! But the people of the world before and now does not fear God. Very few people fear God. And it's something in human that they must feel before they learn. They must be pain before they learn. And the Lord said that he soon comes. Yes.